In other news, the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation, or PAGCOR, brings order in the Okada Manila row. The country's gaming regulator moved to reinstate the ousted board of Tiger Resort Leisure and Entertainment to operate the $3.3 billion Okada Manila. But it has retained Japanese gaming tycoon Kazuo Okada as chairman. PAGCOR's order effectively withdrew its earlier decision to recognize all the board members installed by Okada's group, or Kazuo's group, after ousting the TRLEI board in late May. It ruled the Supreme Court status quo ante order dated April 27, 2022, only resulted in the return of Mr. Kazuo Okada as stockholder, director, chairman, and CEO of TRLEI, and not everybody else's reinstatement. PAGCOR's latest order led to another scuffle between the security groups of the two factions on Friday afternoon at the offices of Okada Manila. Mr. Kazuo Okada's group calls PAGCOR's move illegal and a brazen attempt to defy the Supreme Court order. So Megawide is getting out of the airport business, selling its one-third of the operator and developer of the Mactan Cebu International Airport to Aboitiz Infra Capital, and eventually the remaining two-thirds, for a total consideration of around 25 billion pesos. Megawide's Ed Saavedra now joins us live this morning. Ed, big news. You broke late last week.
Good morning, Mimi. I like your hairstyle.
I like yours too. But Ed, this news, I'm very curious. At what point did you realize that it's time to get out of the airport business? Is it just the pandemic, or is it more fundamental? Plus, of course, the political baggage that comes with it.
Okay. Well, basically, there are two main reasons. No? First is the strategic direction of the company, and also the fair valuation that's on the table. So for the last, since the late last year, we were approached by Aboitiz already and gave us that unsolicited offer. So, and then we thought about this and we discussed and we tried to see, meaning we have to consider many factors, Mimi, you know, that like, it's not only about the financial, right? The monetary side, but also the values that the new investors, a new partner, and also the synergy that we can do. And also where, and also if how they can provide growth and take care also the employees of the company. So all of these fit in to our criteria. Aboitiz is one is I would say the best entity who can do this. We all know that they are also vying for the other provincial airport in the country.
So you're essentially exiting the airport business. I wonder, are you not confident that travel will pick up sooner rather than later?
I guess, okay, from our perspective, no. If you look at the growth for the airport in the Philippines, for provincial airports, I think the Aboitiz have gone a long way already. They're into advanced stage in most of the major provincial airports. Now, it's only actually NAIA that is open, but we still don't know what will be the new direction of the new administration. But if you ask me about NAIA, it really depends. Well, this NAIA thing will be very, very critical. So I think we just have to wait and see to hear what the directions for this administration would want to go, and we will still be open.
Still
because
open.
Because what is important? Yeah, what is important here, Mimi, is that the management know-how is here, is with us. So we have all those know-how. So we're still open.
All right, you can always go back to airports business if it makes sense. I'm very curious, 25 billion, that's the total package amount, and you're getting 60%, so I imagine, and 40 goes to your Indian partner, GMR. So I imagine that's around 15 billion. How far can 15 billion go? What will this 15 billion do?
Okay, so basically, Mimi, it's a combination of, well, we will have war chest to fund our pipeline of projects. We have enough, we have enough in our table to do all the projects that we're working out right now, mm-hmm. particularly in the land transport business. And then also potentially we can go into new sector like affordable housing, in social infrastructure, we have started already in Carbon, and then we have several in the pipelines. We know that most of the public markets in most of the cities here really needs to be modernized. So all of these pipelines, we will use this fund. And of course, it's a combination. The other thing also we need also to manage our liabilities on the parent level in Megawide. And also can be a combination of potentially for like dividends. Mm-hmm. So these three.
All right. You did mention new lines of businesses that you're looking at. Land transport terminals. What's the plan on that? What's the immediate plan on that? How many are you looking at? How many are already underway? How much are you looking to spend per?
Okay. Now, for land transportation, we have around three in the advanced stage and roughly around four in the pre-development phase. Now, for social infra like public market, we know that the carbon is already ongoing in the advanced stage. We're already doing the development of the and construction of this market, but we still have two or three in the pipeline. But we just want to make sure that the prototyping will be successful before we launch the others.
And what about the socialized housing?
Okay, actually, this is quite interesting, Mimi, no? Because affordable housing, it's really, we do a lot of construction, no, for our client in this kind of sector. Now, but we know that with these macroeconomic challenges that are coming in, so we have to be also prudent in going into new sector. But this affordable housing, we want to expand to this business. We're in, it's a forward integration for Megawide. And then we, I mean, personally, I'm very familiar with this sector. So, and we believe that this sector is also an essential business and pandemic resilient.
Are there already sites where you plan to set up your first socialized housing projects? How many?
Okay, actually, Mimi, we have a affiliate which is under CityCorp Holdings, the parent company of Megawide. So it acts like our incubation. So we have currently in the pipeline, there are about a couple of projects, five, six projects ongoing. So potentially we can find a way to structure it, how we can merge or acquire, or we see.
Exciting times ahead. Final question though, before you let the airports business go, did you ever get to break even on the airport project? Because I remember in 2014 when you won it, you also took out a 25 billion peso loan to build the airport. Did you even break even already? Or are you selling this at a loss just to cut loss?
Well, right now, as we speak, the traffic have gone up like I would say 60 to 70%. So we are operating above water. Meaning the domestic side, we're like 80-90% of the traffic, although the international side is still below 50, but generally we're doing above water now.
But as a whole investment, have you made money from the airport at least, or break
yes
even?
I would say yes.
All right. Okay, that's good to know, because that's the question of many viewers and investors. Ed, exciting time said it's been an exciting last 2 to 3 years for Megawide, and now you're diversifying. We're looking forward to more exciting developments from your end as you move to other segments that are also still related to your expertise of construction. It's a pleasure speaking with you, Ed. Thank you for joining us, and congratulations
on
the deal.
Thank you, Mimi. Thank you.
All right.